So, welcome students for the physical chemistry lecture. And up till now in the nuclear chemistry, you have studied what is the nuclear chemistry, the phenomenon of radioactivity or emission of alpha, beta, gamma radiations, then the properties of the alpha, beta, gamma radiation. Then you have seen the decay constant, half-life time. Also, you have derived the equation of lambda, half-life time, that is the T1 half, and the average life time. And after that, we have to see the next point, and that is the detection and the measurement of radioactivity. And here the detection and measurement of radioactivity, it is nothing but the quantitative measurement of the emission of alpha, beta and gamma particles. And for your study, there are two methods. The first method, it is the scintillation counter method, and second method, it is the GM counter, that is the Geiger-Müller counter. Here, this scintillation counter method schematically represented in this diagram here. And in 1941, the scientist H. Kalman, he designed the scintillation counter for the detection and measurement of the alpha particles and beta particles, and not the gamma particles. Remember that. This is the schematic representation. And here the principle of the scintillation counter method is that when the radiation, that means alpha beta particle, it impinges on the scintillator, that means a material which emits a alpha beta particle, and here there is a radioactive element, and this one is the aluminium foil. Here the luminescence produced by the radiation which falls on the radioactive element, it is converted into atomic radiation, it is converted into electronic pulse, and this one is the photo multiplier tube. Here one alpha, when it is emitted, it strikes on the photocathode. Photocathode produces a secondary electrons, and this photo multiplier tube, it is provided with 50 at about 10 to 50 denodes. Here it is first denode, here it is second denode, third denode, fourth, five, and this one is the anode. There are in all 10 to 50 denodes, and here it is the anode. A large pull of electrons. Here secondary electrons are produced. Okay, and this is the schematic representation of scintillation counter, and here it is the detecting device. Then a scintillation counter is an instrument for detecting and measuring ionizing radiation by using excitation effect of the incident radiation on a scintillator material and detecting the resultant light pulse. It consists of a scintillator that generates photon in response to incident radiation. A sensitive photomultiplier tube, that is the PMT, which converts light to an electrical signal, and electronics to process this signal. Then here, as already I have told you, this is a thin aluminium window, and here there are radiations, and here it is a thallium sodium crystal. Here it is the, and here it is the photo cathode. This one is the photomultiplier tube, and here it is the detecting device. As rays, they incident on a radioactive material, it produces a photon, and this photon from the cathode, they get multiplied in the ratio here 1:5 and so on. This is the scintillation counter. Then scintillation counter is an instrument for detecting and measuring ionizing radiation by using excitation effect. This is the diagram. Then working here, working of scintillation counter. Here the electrons here, the low energy photons, they incident on a photocathode and they produces a secondary electrons, and these electrons with the help of denodes, they are passed here from first denode to second, from second to third, from third to fourth, fourth to fifth, and so on. And a large electronic pulse here, it is detected with the help of anode, and here it is a detecting device. Then when an ionizing particle passes into the scintillator material, atoms are ionized along a track. For charged particles, the track is a path of the particle itself. For gamma rays, that means they are uncharged, their energy is converted into an energetic electron via either the photoelectric effect or Compton scattering or pair production. Then the chemistry of atomic de-excitation in the scintillator produces a multitude of low energy photons, typically near the blue end of the visible spectrum. The number of such photons is in a proportion to the amount of energy deposited by the ionizing particle. Here, some portion of these low energy photons arrive at the photocathode of an attached photomultiplier tube. The photocathode emits at most one electron for each arriving photon by the photoelectric effect. And you know, the photoelectric effect, it is the ejection of electron from the metal. Then this group of primary electrons is electrostatically accelerated and focused by an electrical potential so that they strike the first node of the tube. The impact of a single electron on the denode releases a number of secondary electrons, which are in turn accelerated to strike the second denode. Each subsequent denode impact releases further electrons, and so there is a current amplifying effect at each denode stage. Each stage is at a higher potential than the previous to provide the accelerating field. The resultant output signal at the anode is in the form of measurable pulse. For each group of photon that arrived at the photocathode and is passed to processing electronics, the pulse carries information about the energy of the original incident radiation on the scintillator. The number of such pulses are per unit time gives the information about the intensity of the radiation. In some applications, the individual pulses are not counted, but rather only the average current at the anode is used as a measure of radiation intensity. And here, suppose this is a alpha ray, it impinges on a photocathode, it produces a electron, and this is the first diode. This electron, it gets amplified. Suppose from one electron there are 5 secondary electrons are produced, and here the 5 electrons again they produces 5 into 5, that means 25 electrons at the third diode, then 25 into 5 electrons at the fourth, and similarly a large number of pull of the electrons, it is counted at the detecting device, and at the last we have a detecting device. That means the atomic radiation is converted into electronic pulse, and that electronic pulses are measured with the help of neon tubes. This is the working of scintillation counter. Then the scintillator must be shielded from an ambient light so that external photons do not swap the ionization events caused by incident radiation. To achieve this, a thin opaque foil such as aluminized layer is oftenly used, though it must have a low enough mass to minimize unique attention of the incident radiation being measured. Then the applications of scintillation counter. The scintillation counters are used to measure radiation in a variety of applications, including handheld radiation survey meters, personal and environmental monitoring for radioactive contamination, medical imaging, radiometric assay, nuclear security, and nuclear plant safety. This is about the scintillation counter method. We summarize the working of here scintillation counter. When an ionizing particle passes into the scintillator material, atoms are ionized along this track. The photon from the scintillation strikes a photocathode and emits an electron, which accelerated by a pulse and produce a voltage across the external resistance. This voltage is amplified and recorded by a electronic counter. This is the working of scintillation counter. And for tomorrow, we will see the GM counter.